Today, I'm going to show you some really cool experiments you can try out at home. For the first one, we're going to start by filling up a large glass vase with cold water. Then take a small glass bottle and tie a string or a thread to the top of it. I'm using this clear fishing wire, and we'll be using this to lower it into the vase later. Next, take some food colouring, I'm using red, and pour some into the bottle. Then fill the bottle up with some very hot water. This water's not quite boiling. When it's full, lift it up by the string and lower it into the vase. The moment it gets submersed by the cold water, the hot red water starts to escape out of the bottle. Hot water rises, and you can see this happening inside the vase. As the hot water rises out of the bottle, cold water slowly replaces it. It looks really cool, and it's great to watch. Eventually, the hot water will cool down to the point where it doesn't rise out of the bottle anymore. When this happens, you can remove the bottle. And if you like, you can sit it in a pan of hot water to heat it back up. Then, when it's hot, reuse it again. Pretty cool, huh? It's like an underwater volcano. I decided to try doing this same experiment with a glass jar. I used a screwdriver to pierce three holes in the lid. Then I tied on some string and added some food colouring, and filled it with hot water. I can fit a lot more hot water in here than I could in the bottle, so hopefully it'll retain the heat and stay active for longer. I lowered it into the vase, and straight away you can see the water starting to rise. It's predominantly coming out of one hole, with a little trickle out of the other. I think the hole at the back is allowing cold water into the jar to replenish the escaping hot water. It's circulating through the jar, and it looks great. This time it stayed working for a lot longer too. For the next one, I'm taking a couple of drinking straws . If they're bendable straws like this, I'm cutting them just below the bend. Next, I took a bit of plasticine, pushed it onto the table, and used it to hold one of the straws upright like this. Then I took a couple of small birthday cake candles, and we want to try and fit them inside of the straw. If the straw's too small, you can use some scissors to slice the end and open it up enough to hold the candle. Do the same at the other end, and it should look like this. Next, I'm going to take a sewing needle, measure the halfway point of the straw, and push the needle through the center of the straw, like this. Pin it to the top of the other straw, And there we have our candle seesaw. Light it up and see what happens. The idea is, as one candle melts, it gets shorter and becomes lighter, so it raises to the top. Then, because the other candle is facing downhill, it melts quicker than the higher candle, and the whole process reverses. It kind of worked a little bit, but not very well. I think there was a bit too much friction where the straw rotates on the needle. So I blew out the candles, took it all apart, and I heated up a paperclip to melt a larger hole through the centre of the straw. I fitted new candles and added a little plasticine at each end for weight. I slid the needle through the larger hole and pinned it to the straw. This time you can see it had a lot freer movement. It spins a lot easier. I balanced it up by removing plasticine. Then lit the candles. And it worked far better. As one candle gets shorter and lighter, it rises to the top and waits for the other one to melt. Do make sure you blow the candles out before it gets to the end, or they could burn the straws. Once you're done, if you want to, you can remove the old candles and slide in new ones. It's a really cool experiment, and it's great fun to see. For the next one, I'm going to use this vase of water again. I'm taking some shaving foam, and I'm going to spray a layer of it on top of the water like this. Next, take some food colouring, dribble a bit over the shaving foam like this, and watch what happens. The colouring slowly works its way down through the foam and punctures a hole through it. So we have this sort of rainy effect of colour dribbling out of the foamy cloud. It looks really cool and it's dead easy. I'm adding a bit of red colouring too. It's almost the opposite of the experiment we did earlier. It's good fun to watch, and it's amazing when the colour first breaks through the cloud. I repeated the experiment a few times, and here's some of my other clips. Thank you. I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. If you want to see more, you can click on the links or take a look at my YouTube channel page. Stay safe, have fun, and as always, thanks for watching.